poetry is oxygen for me. In my country, from my childhood, I start writing poetry. This is very connected with my language. Bengali language is the sweetest language in the world. In Bangladesh, I was born in capital city, Dhaka. My area environment was very, very good for the literature and culture. Before I came in Singapore, I was a freelance journalist. I decided to come to Singapore to earn money and support my family, make a good future. When I come here, I want to know more about Singapore literature arts. So I save my coffee money every day. I bought one extra times. And I find where is the poem, where is the literature in this newspaper. I did that few months, but could not find single poem, single literature item in that newspaper. That I realized Singapore is a poetry-free country. So that time I find out I have to do something with my fellow worker who came from Bangladesh. So luckily that time I meet some friends who love poem, who love singing. So that time we meet together every Sunday after work. Sunday also we work. So after work we meet there and we share our poetry. Here I am working as a quality controller, interior design. I living in a worker dorm, that is the woodland area in Singapore. It's like we are inside the cage. one of my roommates do jokes. Some people will come to our dorm. If they want to know about a migrant worker's dorm life, they buy ticket and they visit the zoo. The environment is unhealthy and unacceptable. The scenery was very scary. When the virus spread in the dorm, one room inside, they are living 12 to 20 people. 100 plus people use one common toilet area. And this pandemic time, always we hear instruction from Minister of Health that we have to maintain 1 meter distance. But in the room when you go, they are no have space to maintain 1 meter distance. 12 people who are living in a small room. And every day we see so many ambulance come and go. And they take the suspected COVID patient from the dorm every day. One information, that is the fake information, that was viral in the social media that time, was who will be infected COVID. So government will be kill them. So actually that also very scary. The day I find out that my full body is very painful, and afternoon I find out I cannot breathe properly, then I go to the hospital. That time my wife called in my phone, then she asking me, where are you? Then when I say that I am inside the ambulance and I going to hospital, oh my God, she screamed. So that was very emotional. A moment, but when I go to hospital, they receive me very well. That was really one good learning for me, how the doctor, nurse, how they take care migrant workers. They take care us as a patient. They not treat us that we are migrant worker or we are local. I am not fully recovered yet. Still, I am going with some physical and mental problem. Hopefully, I can recover soon. How I can explain that emotional stage when we was quarantined inside the room? Some are losing their memory. Some become crazy, they make noise. They shout each other inside the room. They cannot control their emotion. They shout with their family over the phone because they cannot control their emotion because of the environment. This environment actually very harmful for the mental health. In the dorm, I am a community organizer. So we find out we have to talk more with them. So we more active in the online in that time when we was in quarantine. Because we are doing mental health activity in the dorm, like yoga session. Also, we start meditation and some exercise, physical exercise. Also, sharing session, sharing story, poetry reading session. We are on the way to the new normal. Poetry helped me to come out from that mental sickness.
তোমার মতো আমারও মন খারাপ হয়। প্রকৃতি ছাড়া তখন কোনো কিছুই ভালো লাগে না। প্রকৃতি এক অন্যরকম জাদুর ছোঁয়া। তুমি যাও সমুদ্র স্নানে, কাঁধে ছিপ তুলে নদীর তীরে, ফুলের বাগানে, গাছের শীতল ছায়ায়, আর আমি যাই যন্ত্রের প্রচণ্ড শব্দের ভেতর।